Apple just announced iOS 26 at WWDC, and the beta is already available for those who want to try the all-new liquid glass design, and with it we get a redesigned camera app. But if you are expecting new features like LUT support and an improved UX, you will be sorely disappointed. The TLDR is that the native camera app on iOS 26 is an unimaginative shitshow, offering zero meaningful improvements over iOS 18 and is objectively worse in nearly all regards. Let's take a look. I have the iOS 26 beta running on the 15 Pro Max and iOS 18.5 running on the 16 Pro Max. Let's launch the camera. Instantly, we can see how iOS 26 has redistributed the interface as well as simplifying it. For example, in photo mode, the ability to quickly toggle on RAW is now nested beneath the format picker. As a result, it takes 3 taps to enable Pro RAW on iOS 26 versus just a single tap on iOS 18. So simplicity of presentation is valued more highly than economy of use in iOS 26. The mode picker is restricted to only ever displaying 2 modes on iOS 26, whereas iOS 18 will display a total of 5, making it possible to jump directly from photo to cinematic mode with a single tap. On iOS 26, we are forced into either tapping repeatedly until we get to our desired mode, or swiping over it, which makes it more fiddly and easy to overshoot the mark. Let's jump into video mode, which is what filmmakers are going to be most interested in. White over black on iOS 18 creates high contrast buttons that are much easier to see, especially when filming in bright conditions. Just like with Pro RAW in photos, toggling Apple Lock on and off under video mode goes from a one-tap operation on iOS 18 to a 3-tap operation on iOS 26. However, the new format picker in iOS 26 does make frame rate selection more economical at times, as you don't need to toggle through available frame rates. And yes, iOS 26 retains support for PAL frame rates, which can be enabled under iOS settings. Gone is the action mode button by default in iOS 26, however we can restore it under iOS 26 settings, camera, indicator menu, under composition. To access additional controls on iOS 18, you could simply swipe up anywhere on the interface. On iOS 26, this is no longer supported in the viewfinder and limited to below the lens picker icons. The much larger liquid glass element removes the ability to enable Apple Lock ProRes from here, which is duplicated functionality on iOS 18, but it also hides the record button, which is a shame if you need to quickly try and initiate a recording in a single tap with this open. Annoyingly, you can't swipe it away easily either, like you can on iOS 18, as you often accidentally minimize the app. Additionally, with the mode button and controls now relocated beneath the record button, it is easy to accidentally engage the app switcher, an issue not present in iOS 18. But the real issue with the iOS camera app on iOS 26 is most evident when we rotate into landscape, which for many filmmakers is the default orientation for 16:9 content. The format display and picker is not optimized for landscape and looks awful. On iOS 18, the frame rate and resolution are displayed correctly, even though ProRes Log is not. And if you were hoping for LUT support, sorry, you get lens cleaning hints instead. Yay! If we jump over to iOS camera settings, we have very little new here. Minor repositioning of some elements like photographic styles. Under record video, we have 0 new features, and this is where you can enable show PAL formats. Under composition, new to iOS 26 is indicators, which lets you restore elements Apple have removed from the camera UI by default. It doesn't offer any new functionality, and the only other new feature is lens cleaning hints, which you can disable if you don't want a suggestion from Apple. So all in all, a truly underwhelming camera update from Apple here. It's depressing to see Apple's once amazing interface and UX design continue to deteriorate. So with iOS 26 now more than ever, you'll be wanting to embrace third-party apps as your everyday camera. For stills, Not Boring Camera, which just launched, is the native app killer. And for video, you'll want Blackmagic Camera. Both can be mapped to your lock screen, camera control, and action buttons. And of course, I have tutorials to help you master both here on the channel. Let me know what you think of the camera app in iOS 26 in the comments below. And please like and share this video. I'll see you in the next one.